Hey, what's up, you guys? We are cautiously optimistic. Back today again.
I'm back.
Rob is back. And we are making a new video today about Orange.
Yeah, they tried to kick me out, but it didn't work.
Yeah, we tried to just cut him.
Even the fact that I dropped Orange wasn't enough to not make me be part of this video.
Yeah, I wanted Rob to be part of this video because we have obviously drastically different views about Orange.
I finished it and I didn't.
It and he didn't. And I just wanted to kind of get Rob's perspective because I actually avoided this show for the longest time
because of what Rob said.
Well, hello. Now, you might have noticed something different because you clicked on a review for Orange and there were two guys and now there's just this insert of me. Hi, I'm Matt. So I just wanted to make this insert because when editing this video, I realized that there was a really shitty summary of Orange and I kind of missed a few things. So there might be inserts throughout the video. So I'm just gonna forewarn you that there might just be inserts of me like clarifying some things. But the first thing is the summary. If you guys don't know what Orange is about, it's about a girl named Naho who receives a letter one day and she takes it to school with her. She doesn't open it until the end of the day. And then at the end of the day, she realizes that it's a letter from her future self, which basically tells Naho about her friend's suicide that she had just met this day, like this kid that she just met. So that is the summary of Orange.
In this review, there are going to be a ton of spoilers because
you can't really review a show without spoiling it.
Exactly.
Without going in depth and talking about it.
So unless you're being really like ambiguous about
it. Yeah, but then you're not really giving any good information.
Exactly.
So then it was good, watch it.
So I'm gonna be really frank. The first episode pissed me off. Like, really bad.
I thought it was okay.
And the only reason that it really pissed me off was because of the one big fact that I avoided this show completely.
Because of what I said.
Of what Rob said, and that is...
Let me say it.
Yeah, go for
okay,
it.
Okay, so... The reason I stopped watching it was because I realized... I got through episode 3. So that's when, after they stop him from killing himself, and he's now dating the bitch girl. Mm-hmm. The reason I stopped watching it was because I got like 2 weeks behind. Mm-hmm. And I would just see it in my Crunchyroll queue. Like the thumbnail was like a picture of like, I think it was Suga's eye. And like, every time I would go on Crunchyroll, I would see his eye. And I'd just be like, I gotta get caught up on Orange. I gotta get caught up on Orange. I would never do it. And then I was like 5 weeks behind. And then I thought to myself, okay, I need to get caught up on Orange. But then this is when I had my epiphany. And the reason I don't like Orange. The reason I don't like Orange is because in the future, Naho, the main girl, is married to Sua. Mm-hmm. And they have a kid together.
Yeah. And it's fucked up.
Then she's sending, like, letters back in time to prevent, like, the dude that she has a crush on from killing himself to, at that point, I assumed was purportedly be with him and not end up with the dude that she has a kid with and loves. I thought that was fucked up. And I'm like, good, now I don't have a reason now I have no reason to catch up, I can drop it, and I did.
Yeah.
I got to episode 3.
So, yeah, you see in the first episode that she ended up marrying Sua and has a kid with him, who the kid is redheaded and fucking adorable. And I just think it's stupid. Like, that part really pissed me off about Orange, and not only did Orange, like, it kind of rubbed me the wrong way also that, like, I didn't think that Orange really looked the best. A lot of the smiles on a lot of the characters was really awkward.
The teeth was weird. It was, like, how, like, in every, like, thing that's, like, really, like, hyper-realistic, at least, like, in, like, 3D modeling, like, in, like, super high-realistic or high-resolution realistic images and that kind of stuff, the teeth are always the weirdest thing.
Yeah, the teeth are always the weirdest
thing. The teeth always look off, because they're either, like, weirdly spaced or too perfect, or just, there's always something just really wrong with them and they look weird.
Yeah.
But the teeth in Orange look weird.
Yeah, they looked really weird.
And I don't know if that's because of the art style, like, the art style is pretty unique, but...
It is pretty unique.
It's...
But it was the teeth. It was the teeth and the smiling that, like, really got weird. Me in a lot of the scenes.
Orange.
Ishi dushi.
He's the best character in Orange.
So yeah, the first episode really pissed me off, but then I decided that I was going to watch the second one. So our guest Justin, actually, he and I were watching Orange together, because now me, Rob, and him are now doing this thing where we pick a show and...
Anime book club, basically.
Yeah, and we just watch it all together. But yeah, so during the second, and Justin felt the same way about the first episode. He just felt like that the art style was kind of like, it was very unique, and I didn't think it was weird, but he thought the smiling was weird too.
Did you tell Justin what I thought about it?
Yeah.
Okay. So he knew too.
Yeah. So if you see me looking down, I'm looking at the other cast of characters because I literally cannot remember their fucking
forgettable
names because they're forgettable. But likable, but forgettable. And the second episode is where it kind of started kicking off for me, because the second episode is when you kind of find out that his mom killed herself. Kakeru's mom killed herself, and that was their consequence about, like, asking him to hang out with them at the end of school that day instead of him, you know, going home. So yeah, the third episode and on, it just kind of kept inclining and getting better and better and better and stuff like that. But then it kind of declines towards the end, and I'm going to get into like the reasons and like the pros and the cons. So one of the biggest pros about the show is the friends. They're actually really cool, even though they're underdeveloped. The friend group has a really nice chemistry. There's a funny one. There's two funny ones actually that play off.
They all have, it's all the good friend tropes.
It's all the good friend tropes. And yeah, it's,
you can remember them by their tropes better than
you
can by their names. You
have the tough bitch, the funny bitch, the awkward guy, the sports guy. Who is Sua, who's
the
best
girl
guy
who wears too much makeup.
I don't think they have a girl who wears too much
makeup. Isn't that the other girl who's not the tall, smart girl?
No, she's just the funny one.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, they have the smart guy who's awkward, and then they have the suicidal one, which is Kakeru.
The edgelords.
Suicide, if you will. But yeah, the friends are charming, and the whole friend group dynamic is one of the biggest pros about the show. It made me want to keep watching because of all the jokes that Azusa would crack.
What if there was like an alternate, because it's all alternate realities, right?
Yeah.
What if there was an alternate reality of Orange where
it didn't exist?
Where Kakeru is Ikari Shinji from Neon Genesis Evangelion, and they're all like, Shinji, get in the damn robot! And Kakeru's like, no, I got a text from my mom, and I'm gonna kill myself. That's like Ikari does in like every episode. He'd be like the same. No, he wouldn't, because Ikari and Shinji is way better. But it would be the same outcome.
Yeah, probably. It would be. So
that's what you reminded me of when you said that he's like an edgelord.
He is an edgelord.
Suicidal. Like, I immediately thought of Ikari Shinji.
So another big pro that I already kind of mentioned about the show is Sua. A lot of Sua's actions in the show are just very selfless and a lot, like, and just very, like, holy shit, like, that was awesome.
You love Sua.
I love Sua. Sua is the shit. He is, like, the one reason why this show, like, was so good
Sua
to me.
Sua's your husbando.
That he
him,
is.
Him or Kamina?
Sua.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
All the way. All the fucking way. Sua. 100%.
You were destroyed when Kamina perished bravely.
I know, but Sua's just like 100 times better. Like, he chose a life of misery for this man that he met a month ago. What the fuck?
What the fuck?
We went to at Steak and Shake the day after Kamina died. You were like,
I was distraught.
I
had a dream about Kamina.
Yeah, you were like, he's dead. He's gone.
He's just fucking dead.
I'm like, he's like, I gotta buy a Kamina figure now. I'm like, you got $1,000?
Or not. Like, so yeah, those were like the two biggest pros of the shows to me. Besides that, the art style was unique. There weren't any characters that I like absolutely hated, so that was good. I base a lot of like my liking of shows, if like I cannot stand a character, then I really can't stand that show.
Yeah.
I mean, like, obviously the characters that you are meant to hate, you hate. But I want to say, like, the biggest con about this show is the fact that, like, it's a really, like, endearing story about, like, how they're trying to save their friend from committing suicide and stuff like that. But the biggest con to me is not the fact that, like, Sua, and Naho don't get together in the end. It's the simple fact that they met this dude, like, literally, I think it was, like, they knew, like, they knew him for, like, a span of, like, 3 months.
But what the fuck?
Before he killed himself.
No, it was like 2 days.
Before he kills himself?
He was going to.
Oh, because he tried like 2 days.
Yeah.
Later. Yeah. And that's some fuck shit.
It's like 2 days.
Because
doesn't he not almost kill himself because she makes him lunch or whatever?
Yeah.
So he won't give him because she's too socially awkward?
Yeah. Yeah. And a big con, what Rob just mentioned, is like, Naho is very shy, which is fine. Like, I'm a very shy person sometimes in certain situations, so I can understand like her being shy towards Kakeru. Oh my god.
You had a look.
Yeah.
How many times have you said his name? Ikari Shinji, we're just calling him Shinji.
Yeah, yeah. Shinji.
He wishes he was Shinji.
he wishes he was Shinji.
Fucking Subaru.
Yeah, Subaru does.
At least does. You wouldn't know. God, I'm gonna have to, I wish I knew. Someone who watched it, tell me if they show any Kakeru scenes where he quotes the fucking Ikari Shinji unfamiliar ceiling line like Subaru does. Because if he does, then holy fuck.
So like, what I really didn't like about the show was, like I was what Rob mentioned before, Naho is just so socially inept that like, even though Kakeru is like, yeah, Naho, I like you, she still acts like an awkward bitch. And it's like, do you really want to save his life or nah? Because like, to me, to me, it just seems like you're just fucking around at this point. Yeah. Like, I mean, like, I understand, like, being awkward, like, okay, like, I don't know if he likes me or not or whatever, but it's like, it's clear that he does. And it's just like, she doesn't do shit.
Yeah.
And the other thing is that they mentioned how the fuck... Oh, this was another huge reveal in the show, and this is a big spoiler.
It's what I wish happened in a race.
Yeah, and it's that every single person, like, they're in their friend group, got letters from each other in the past.
Do you find out in the future that everyone got them all at once, or do you find out that Sua gets one and then everyone else? Like, what's the order of that? Because you told me that Sua gets one.
So basically, the order of how they all get them, it's basically like...
Like, how's it revealed?
It was revealed that, like, Naho has one, and she's, like, debating on, like, telling her friends, and especially, like, Sua, because the letter kind of alludes to, like, her being like to confiding in Sua. Mm-hmm. And Sua comes to her house. I can't remember exactly why, but he reveals that he got a letter, and that's after like episode six.
So you find out that Sua, at that point, you're the only people who know about it are Naho and Sua.
Yeah, and then in episode eight, it's revealed that basically all of them got letters, but they all decided to ignore them for the most part.
Except for
Naho. Sua ignored it for the first day until he realized that Kakeru's mom killed herself, and then the rest of the friends got letters for, like, they weren't as detailed, they were just, like, talking about certain events that they need to, like, get rid of.
Because, like,
essentially.
When you explained that to me, I was like, oh, that's what I wished happened in a raid.
And that's a big pro of the show, is, like, in that sense it ties together, but then it all goes to fucking shit, because... The friends are like, oh, do you remember like how in high school we talked about black holes? Like, let's go to the Bermuda Triangle and throw these letters in the Bermuda Triangle.
Oh yeah, I totally forgot about that.
and it was just like the dumbest reasoning their letters got to this parallel universe.
They send them through the Bermuda Triangle. Do they just like go on? Do they just?
That's what I was wondering. Never alluded to.
They don't say it. They just
no. It's bullshit. They so just are like.
There's not like a scene with them with Captain Ahab. Like I'm like a fishing.
No.
Like, Scoonie out in the middle.
It's
of
It's just
the
bullshit.
Bermuda
they're
Triangle
like, why don't
like a handful of letters.
They're just literally like, let's write letters and throw them into the Bermuda Triangle. And then you're like, well. And going back to another point that I made earlier that really pissed me off about the show is that, like, you know, Naho has this, like, amazing life with Sua and whatever, and she ends up doing this for Kakeru, like, fully knowing that they were, like, both into each other.
Yeah, it's
at this
just, like,
point.
Weird because at, like, the time, like, from the overall, like, of the series, like, what you were saying, it's more about them trying to prevent him from killing himself so they can't be friends.
Yeah.
But at that point in the beginning,
it very much seems
like she is trying to prevent him because she wants herself in this alternate reality to be with Kakeru.
Right, and, like, that's, like, the beginning of the show, what it seems to come off as, but, like, you get this understanding that, like, the friend group is literally, like, not the same at all, and they don't, like, hang out, they don't, like, really see each other anymore. After Kakeru's death, and it's like all just kind of like tense when they see each other, and like the only thing that they really do is talk about Kakeru or like what they should have done differently.
It's like Anohana, but not as good.
Yeah.
And they're all not in love with the dead Lobby's ghost.
Yes.
Okay, makes sense.
Okay. another pro that I really forgot to talk about is I did mention that Sua is the best, and I'm gonna tell you why now Sua is the best. And this is a major spoiler, and this is what made me like really like this show.
Did he punch Kakeru ever?
I think he did.
good.
Like at the end of the show when he tried to kill himself. Could punch Kakeru, I'm pretty sure.
Continue.
Anyways, so as I was mentioning before, Kakeru, what I had like found out, like when I really thought about the show, like I was really pissed off and I would have really liked it more if like Kakeru and Naho were just like best friends. And that was like the whole purpose of that, like Naho going back in time because she was gonna save her best friend. But it came to me that like he would have killed himself still if like there wasn't a love interest in his group. And it's very much so like shown there because like he writes a letter to himself in the future, like towards the end, because that was like a thing that they did. They realized in the time capsule that Kakeru had like always planned on killing himself because he just kind of talks about everybody else in the group and not himself. And in the new letter, he says like, oh, did you marry Naho? Are you living, like, are you happy every day of your life because you married Naho? So like, it very much so is like, I can come to the conclusion that he would have died if like, if he didn't have a love interest in the group, because he would have been like, fuck it, and just like killed himself.
It sounded very passive aggressive the way you said it.
What?
Are you having great? Are you happy with
Naho? No, literally.
Are you happy?
I'm not even fucking kidding you. Like that's what it says. It's like, are you happy with Naho? Are you happy every day?
It's I like thought it really was funny because the way that you said it sounded very passive aggressive.
It kind of is. But so Sue was the best just because of the simple fact that he tells in his letter to his past self that he should not tell Naho about his feelings for her, and Naho in the future even reveals that like if Sua had revealed his feelings for her, that she would have probably ended up with Sua in the long run anyways, and probably just dated like Kakeru in high school or something like that, because she said that Sua was like more reliable and like
Kakeru's too emo.
Yeah, and she just said that like Sua was just better in every aspect.
He's too unstable.
Yeah, and I think that's what she was kind of like trying to get to. And so Sua basically gives himself like this whole like eternity of sadness and never being with the person that he loves because he's a fucking bro and wants to save his bro, which is also bullshit.
They have a word for that.
What? So yeah, he got cucked like real hard, but yeah, he didn't, though.
It's fine.
But it's really funny because, and like me and Justin were texting about this, but like at the end of the show, Naho kind of talks to she's talking to the group of friends and they talk about like how their letters must have come from parallel universe where like Kakeru died. Oh, they fucking told Kakeru at the end about their letters and he just goes, oh, I thought something was going on.
That makes sense. Literally. I mean, how else would they have gotten to you?
So oh god.
This is a good show.
Yeah.
I'm so glad.
So at the end, like, you know, Sua is like fully knows that like him and Naho get married in this parallel universe that like the letters are sent from. And someone goes like, oh, what if there was a parallel universe that like Naho and Sua got married, and like Sue was like, nope, never, blah, 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 blah. And Naho was like, oh, I'd like that. I'm like, you fucking whore!
There's the future that they went to the Bermuda Triangle.
Yes.
She's with Sua, right?
Yes.
That's what I said. She's with Sua. Then in the show, in the parallel universe that the show takes place in,
yeah.
Who's she with?
Kakeru.
She's with Kakeru?
Yeah!
They're married?
It's like basically summed up that they get married. You can make an assumption that they do.
So I was right!
Yes. Well, no, because it was more so like, the whole reason...
I'm justified. That's exactly the reason.
Their reasoning for the parallel universe was, their reasoning for this whole parallel universe was to make Kakeru happy, and like, they just summed up that Kakeru couldn't be happy without Naho.
Yeah, so I was right. She was sending letters to herself from the past when she could end up with her... With Kakeru.
No, but she says in the future...
That's how she... Okay, she didn't intend it to be, but that's what she did.
So, in the in the future, or in the other universe in the future, she ends up with Sua, okay?
Right.
And she says that she would have ended up with Sua anyways because he revealed his feelings.
She said that in the future.
In the future.
Okay. And then in the KAKERU timeline.
They said, what if there was an a parallel universe where you married Sua? She was like, I would like that. Yeah. Yeah.
So she's just like all over the place.
So at the end, I did enjoy this show, minus like the cons and how we were talking shit about it. I ended up giving it, originally I gave it an 8, but now I'm giving it a 7. I think it's standing at Mal as like a 7.5, and I can't agree with that more. It's a good show for what like the pros are good for, but the cons are just like, they're like more towards the end, and that's why I say the show declines a lot at the end. And my biggest thing is just that, like, that she didn't get together with Sua, man. Like, that just really irks me. Another really weird thing about the show is that at the end, you don't really even see what happens in another timeline. Like, you don't, or in that timeline in the future. You don't see them, like, all grown up like you do in the other universe where, you know, KAKERU is dead. So, I mean, yeah. And I just think it's stupid because the whole thing that triggered his event was that he got his mom's phone and she had a draft that was going to be sent to KAKERU, and like right before she killed herself, basically being like, you should be happy and blah, 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 blah. And that's what triggered him to want to commit suicide. And he almost fucking commits suicide.
They fake you out, right?
Yeah, they fake you out in the last episode. And I'm just like, so literally everything they did was for nothing. Except for one character said to destroy his bike, and then he ends up doing that, so KAKERU isn't on his bike, and instead is walking.
So it's the first episode of Death Note.
Yeah.
That's what happens.
Yeah.
Like, he's chasing a woman on his motorcycle, and he's like, yeah, I'm gonna rape you, and then he gets hit by a bus.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Except, and he was gonna take his bike, and he would've been dead if he took his bike in this timeline. So, I gave it a 7, and that's what it's gonna stay at. It might lower, but it was a good ride. I enjoyed the characters. The story at the end was just like, what?
If Sua wasn't your husbando, what would you rate this show?
Probably, oh my god.
If Sua was not your favorite.
Probably a 5 or a 4, honestly.
Sua's enough to make it a 7.
If Sua wasn't the way that he was, this show wouldn't be as good as it was.
Okay.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, it does.
So, there you have it. Rob dropped it. I gave it most people's eyes is a good score.
I don't review shows that I drop. I don't score shows that I drop.
So, yeah. But Rob would probably give it a 1 out of 10. No, because it's not as bad as whatever.
It sounds like a 4, to be honest. But so, I can't judge. I didn't watch it.
Yeah. So, there you have it, guys. If you want to watch Orange,
don't.
I guess do it.
Bermuda Triangle.
Bermuda Triangle! That's the whole premise.
That's the moral of the story.
Yeah.
If your life is fucked up and you wish things were different, just
go to the Bermuda Triangle.
Charter a boat to the Bermuda Triangle. Or just write it on an envelope to the Bermuda Triangle and the mail person will take care of it.
Exactly.
That'll be great.
Yeah. And then we could have a parallel universe.
And then you can date Ikari Shinji too.
Yeah.
Unfamiliar ceiling.
So, and I know this review was very scatterbrained. I just kind of started talking about whatever came to my mind first.
It's fine.
So, I mean, you got the score, and I hope you laughed at the cons that we laughed at, and just, like, laughed at, like, the stupid shit from the show. I always like to talk about the worst of the worst about the show, because if you think you could hold that, or, like, not really hold it accountable for it, then you're probably gonna, like,
yeah, it's funny when you listen to a review, and all they do is talk shit about the show, and they're like, it was great!
Yeah, it was great! Like,
it's like, this part was stupid, this part was awful, I hate this, 9 out of 10.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's just, like, one of those things where if it's not, like, a 9 or above for me, I can't really tell you anything that was, like, outstandingly good besides Sua, and, like, the dynamic of the friend group, because, like, there were obviously other good moments, but they usually fell into one of the two categories of Sua or the friend group. This show was very controversial when it came out because it rose to the top and then people were slamming it back down because people thought it was shit and generic. So there you have it. Rob dropped it. I gave it a 7. Have you watched Orange? What were your thoughts on it? Do you love Sua like I do? Because I fucking love Sua.
Do you think Naho is a slut?
Do you think Naho is
or that KAKERU is like the cringiest edgelord since...
Oh my god.
And if he can.
The biggest cringiest moment of this fucking show is he's sitting in like... So basically episode 9 kind of takes you back from it to the parallel
You won't let it end.
Where he dies, okay?
What?
Yeah, so episode 9 is kind of like showing the events that like... That if they didn't... Like, what caused him to make suicide, or to make suicide, to kill suicide.
To make suicide.
So literally, he's sitting with his friends from Tokyo, because he moved from
Tokyo. Oh, and they're like, yeah, you should totally kill yourself?
No! So what happens is, like, they're like, how are you doing after your mom died? And he's like, honestly, like, she killed herself, and I want to kill myself every day. And then they just sit there in silence, and one of the dudes is like, that's a really funny joke. And then they go on.
Suicide's not a joke.
Suicide is not a joke, people! Depression. That was fucked up! And then he correlates that his old friends would be like his new friends, and his new friends wouldn't want to hear about his problems. Which is like Sua and all of them. So that's Orange. Thank you guys so much for watching. What did you think of Orange? Put it in the comments section down below.
This is the fifth time we're ending this video.
And we will see you next time. Bye, guys.